My name's Zwide Daka. I'm the sales and marketing manager for Afco Equipment Zambia. And Afco Equipment Zambia is an authorized dealer for John Deere equipment. That includes John Deere tractors, John Deere planters, quite a number of John Deere equipment. And Afco has been in existence for the last 20 years. It's been supporting both the commercial side, the small scale and emergent farmers, including weekend farmers. So the first qualification for any farmer is that you have to have land. John Deere Financial, it's a facility that can be tailor-made to suit each and every customer that comes our way. So John Deere Financial will subsidize the interest rate that is given, that comes from any commercial bank. It is tailor-made to suit your cash flow. Very few farmers are on title. So most of the people that we work with, be it mostly on the small scale side, most of it is customary land. We still work with them. What we just require from them is just to give us a brief history of how they've been doing their farming in the past 2-3 years, and their yield, and are they improving or not. So most of the equipment that Afco brings in are usually imported. We are not a manufacturing company here in Zambia, but we bring in according to what the market demands. So we bring in most of the equipment, like for example, the market at the moment demands for precision equipment, and of course, equipment that will help safeguard the nature, rather the your soils. You are talking of your conservation reapers. So your conservation reapers do not only help you conserve on your soil. It helps you prevent erosion. It helps you reduce your cost on fuel, because with reapers you're only reaping where you're going to plant. These reapers are in various sizes, and those various sizes come from small scale up to commercial. They accommodate everyone. They are quite affordable, and one of our cheapest reapers, which is an entry level, costs about $1,800 to accommodate all the farmers, be it commercial, be it small scale. We are working hand in hand with other stakeholders, like the financing stakeholders. We work together with Aglisco, it's a leasing company. We work with Stanbic Bank, we work with Zanaco, FNB, in trying to help a customer acquire those equipment at a reduced interest rate through John Deere, what we call John Deere Financial. The way we trade, it's through cash. The customer would give a deposit through the whichever lending institution they are using, or whichever lending institution where we have introduced them to. Then that institution will pay Afco in cash. Then according to what you have agreed, the banks as well as the customer. So normally the agreement is between the three parties. That's Afco, the lending institution, and the customer. The customer, there's a minimum deposit that the customer puts in to acquire a particular equipment. And that deposit goes straight to the bank. The bank will pay Afco in cash. Then the customer starts paying back to the bank. It could be monthly, it could be quarterly or annual. When a customer gets a machine from Afco, of course they get a free training. It doesn't matter the area, they could be in Shangombo, we do a training at our own cost. And aside that, we also give packages, or rather gifts, like a small fertilizer applicator, just to help encourage other farmers. So normally the training is all dependent on how fast gets hold of the way to use the equipment. So our tractors are quite affordable. They're quite affordable, and it's a good brand. It's a very robust brand. And to make it more affordable, no wonder we are working with other stakeholders, because knowing that most clients may not want to pay outright cash. So you're looking at a lending institution trying to hold the farmer's hand, saying, okay, we can help you pay this for this tractor, depending on how we would structure the loan. Mind you, the loans, the facilities will run from a minimum of 1 year up to a maximum of 5 years. So, and most of the challenges coming through the exchange rates, because of late the exchange rate has been skyrocketing and it doesn't seem to slow down, and that really has really affected any business, and that has really limited the number of sales we get from clients, because today you give them a quote, tomorrow it's a different price. So actually working with these lending institutions, it has really helped us in such a way that if a customer makes a deal with the banks or and us, the rate is locked. So even if the rate gets to 30 and the loan runs for the next 5 years, they'll still pay at the current rate on the day of signing of the contract. So there's been instances where farmers have defaulted. In most cases, would seek audience. We've been seeking audience with farmers. We sit with them and restructure the whole plan to see how best they can finish that loan. So normally in these facilities, collateral is the equipment. So in cases where the farmer has completely failed to pay what's due, banks will repossess, because remember the banks, the equipment, whatever equipment the client might have, is in the name of the bank. So in cases where they have defaulted, the bank will repossess that, give them a grace period in which to clear that. After that, then the bank will decide on what to do with that equipment. So we have after sales backup for our equipment. We have a very able and robust parts section, which stocks most of the service parts, including repair parts. Aside the parts section, we also have a very, very good service workshop, which also helps in helping the farmer to maintain the equipment in order. We look at Zambia as the main focus. That's our main target. But other than that, we also export to countries like Congo, Zimbabwe, Tanzania, including Botswana. So for the price, it remains the same, regardless where you're buying in Zambia, you're buying from Zambia, within Zambia, or you're buying, it's going across, being exported. The government has been very supportive, especially the new law concerning VAT. The scrap of VAT on all tractors above 90 horsepower. Initially, those tractors used to attract VAT, and that is a huge saving on the client. So I must say the government is really making the environment conducive enough for doing business. The agriculture sector is growing and has the potential to grow even bigger from where we are now. At this stage, people have realized that Zambia should be the food harbor for the whole lot of Southern Africa, because we've had the last 2 years we have had good rains, the economy has been stable, making it easy for any investor to come and invest within the country. So it's highly competitive because we've got plenty of players on the market. So what has helped us maintain in this competitive industry, maintain our stability, is the service that we offer to the client, which makes them come back and introduce us to other clients. The services that includes, of course, like I mentioned, the backup. All our equipment are well backed up. That has really helped clients to service their machines on time. And again, the facilities we offer in terms of financing, because even if a farmer doesn't have the cash at that particular time, the facilities, the finance facilities are tailor-made to suit his cash flows. So that really helps us stand out in this business. The equipment that is of utmost demand is the John Deere tractors. And in this case, we're talking of the what you call the 3000 series, which is 45 horsepower, and the 5000 series, which is about the 75 horsepower. The 45 horsepower is a tractor that helps, it's entry point for someone who's trying to get into farming. And the 75 horsepower is a medium tractor that gives you room for expansion. It also helps you have that leverage to hire out equipment to your neighbors so that you can give the tractor a service. It depends on seasons mostly. Commercial farmers, yes, we cannot rule them out. But of late, for the past 2 years, there's been a lot of sales coming from small and medium scale farmers. These are guys that are expanding their fields and of course trying to just improve their yields. So we work with other stakeholders like Conservation Farming Unit. We do organize field demos to take this equipment to the farmer out there, show them how they work and encourage them to get those equipment so that they can improve their yields. So we arrange them depending on the activity of a particular of that particular time in the season. So we do our first one is harvesting in a year. So like right now we're busy preparing a few days for harvesting. The next will be land prep, and again after that they'll be planting demos. So we'll move across Zambia from town to town, especially in those active places like your central province, southern province, eastern province, northern and northwestern, including Copper Belt and Lusaka. These programs are quite effective because not everyone has got the liberty to come, or rather the finances to travel to Lusaka and look at this equipment. They would only be admiring it either from their neighbors or from social media and other places. So we take to them so that they can get encouraged. Of late, it has been more of the Copper Belt, Central Province and Southern Province. Northwestern is coming up pretty well. Eastern Province also coming up. So we're looking at spreading our wings to those other areas like Northern, Wapula, to bring everyone on board and make sure that everyone is mechanized. These trainings are annually. It's year in, year out. So these are free trainings to the clients out there. We bear the cost of shipping the equipment from our premises to wherever the farmers are. So there's no need for someone to pay to come and attend our few days. So we would like to encourage every farmer out there and those that are in the process of getting into farming to visit AFCI Equipment Zambia. We have what you need to get you started, and we will definitely hold your hand as you are in that process of getting your feet together. AFGRI is a company for the farmers, for all farmers. AFGRI will give you the best service. Those that can access us through our Facebook page is AFGRI Equipment Zambia, or you can also visit our website www.afgri.co.za.